It is a major milestone for the city's metro system. 50 years ago today, Montrealers took their commute underground. Andy DeMelt has a look at the metro's beginnings and what its future holds.
It's rush hour at Lionel-Groulx Metro Station, a chance to observe what Matt McLaughlin calls a masterpiece.
I see the artwork here, and I see the beauty, and I see the people, the flows of people.
McLaughlin even created a fan page, metrodemontreal.com, complete with a rating for every station.
This station, for one, for its planning. Acadie Station for its color scheme and its homage to the Art Deco style, and Champ de Mars for the most beautiful artwork.
It's also a favorite for the metro's unofficial historian, Benoit Clairoux.
The first time I took the metro was to go to see the expos at the Olympic Stadium. And for some reason, it was love at first sight.
A passion that produced two books about the history of the metro.
They've talked about the metro maybe 50 years before it was built.
The very first plans were for tunnels for the city's tramways, but the blueprint for the metro as we know it came under Mayor Jean Drapeau in 1961.
We're very proud we will have here in Montreal a network of metro.
Drapeau is commonly known as the father of the metro, but Clairoux says that's not quite true.
The father of the metro is Lucien Saulnier. Lucien Saulnier was his right-hand man. Drapeau, like many of the people of his day, he thought for a time, yeah, that you could solve all traffic problems with cars.
He quickly got on board and construction got underway. The network entirely underground for smaller metro cars on tires.
With the smaller cars, you could have only one tunnel. And then you could save a lot of money on construction.
It cost $213 million to build the first 20 stations, all done within 5 years.
They didn't waste too much time, you know, in studies and stuff like that. The yellow line was decided, you know, like during a night. So they asked the engineer, so can you do it? And by the way, you have to answer in the next few hours, you know.
As the system expanded, construction pushed beyond the decarry.
They started the blue line, but what happened in those days is that with the inflation and everything, the metro started to cost a lot of money.
And plans for a westbound extension were shelved by the PQ in 1979.
The Quebec government started to pay. And of course, when somebody starts to pay something, they decide, well, since I pay for it, why don't I decide where it goes?
Laval was the first extension in almost 20 years, but now a new window of opportunity. The Prime Minister promising to open up the coffers, $48 billion for new infrastructure.
Over the next year, we'll be developing the second phase of public transit investments to fund major projects like new bridges and new subway lines.
With Ottawa offering financial support, the Couillard government calls the Blue Line extension a top priority, but one it still needs to study with no specific timeline to share today.
We're waiting, as you are waiting, for any announcement.
Until then, the STM is spending upwards of $300 million a year on maintaining existing infrastructure.
So it's a never-ending process maintaining the metro.
So was replacing its aging fleet with 52 new Azure trains by 2018.
More room in the metro, more light.
And more service.
We'll be adding 14 trains to our fleet. That will give us the opportunity to put more trains on the track every morning.
The plan also to have cell phone service across the network.
Now you'll be able to start your day, send emails, call someone, schedule some meetings.
What began 50 years ago today changed the way people get around the city, and half a century later, it's hard to imagine Montreal without it. Annie DeMelt, CTV News.